When you don't understand the word, ask me for Chaval. That so all of a sudden, after 30 years after Paulo start in the thing, Shimon Kefa go to Rome and work with him. He becomes the first step, and he asked to be on the top of a cella, you know, on the tzur, the Vatican, and they bring him his food, only bread and water, because he don't want to eat what he told them that you can eat.
זה במדרש?
כן, 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 כן. Now, he was a chaitan. He was writing songs. Shimon Kefa, he was a very big chaitan, and we read in the tefillot, things that he wrote after he became the Pope. So he was in Kefir with Chazal, after he became the first Pope. You believe this? And not only this, when he died, Chazal said that we have not to eat. He died in the day of Tet Betevet. Chazal said, we have to not eat in this day. You will find this in the internet, 5 reasons why we fast in Tet Betevet. Third reason, second reason, this was the day that Jesus died too. Because 25 December in the Efes Lassira, 25 December, it was Tet Betevet.
It's the birthday. Basically.
It's the birthday of Jesus, formal birthday of Jesus. And in the same day he died, Tet Betevet. So they said two reasons why far. First of all, no, they said 5 reasons, but two of the reasons why, because we don't like Jesus and he born on this day. Second, because we like Shimon Kefa.
Uh-huh.
We like him. He's a tzaddik and he died in this day. He helped us.
Because he took the Jews who believed in Jesus away.
Away. Because he was together with Paulus. Not he finished now in the Judaism. It's not serious. Now we have a mission with the going. Until we have 2,000 years mission with the going. After we will come back to the Jews. Now nothing to do with the Jews.
Sure. This is in the Midrash.
Now when I read this story, I came to my Rav and I told him, listen, who made the Christianity? This is the Chazal. Our Savior made the Christianity. It's not Jesus. So how can you say Megalgalim Chut al Yedei Zakai V'Chov al Yedei Chayav? You cannot tell me this anymore.
You cannot tell me that
from evil can evil and from good can good. You cannot tell me this anymore. Because Paulo was not the Talmid of Yeshua, even not one day. He was never the Talmid, he was Talmid of Rabbi Gamliel. Everybody knows this. So you cannot lashim and say, Jesus, you're not good because Christianity comes from... No, Christianity didn't come from Jesus, Christianity came from Chazal.
And from Kefa and the Pesha.
Yeah, from Chazal.
Okay.
No, I came to my Rabbi and said, tell me, Rabbi, this truth, this story, that is Musma, is recognized like a true story, he told me yes. And then he shared some encyclopedia. Oh, here we have a proof. I just give you one example of proof. A book of Yehudai Hasid, Sefer Hasidim. They said in the encyclopedia you will find something in Siman, Kuf Tzadik Aleph. All right, we open the book in Kuf Tzadik Aleph, there's nothing, so took it out. We find a book that they don't took it out. And what he writes there, Yehudai Hasid. And my Rav said, if Yehudai Hasid says so, it's 100% Musmar.
Mm-hmm.
It's
reliable.
If regard 100% reality. If you guys are successful, like is a big so what he said in this place, he told, he asked the question, we are allowed to give bad name for the Meshumadim. You know, Jews that become a Christian, we can't call him a dog or you know, bad name.
You can.
You can. He said, yes, you can. Mm-hmm. And he gives you exams. He gives you exams. And one of them that he gives is Shimon Kefa. Oto Tzadik, he called him Tzadik. Then Torim Acharav, and they all after him. And they call him Peter Hamor. Peter Hamor is the first donkey that they born. Mm-hmm. Because it's Petros, St. Peter, so they call him Peter Hamor. So he gives an exam, but when he gives this exam, he writes in the parallel that he is a tzaddik and the wrong after him. Alright?
He's a tzaddik because he's talking with the
Chazal like Shimon Kefa. In the first step, Chazal like him. We every Shabbat we say in the tfilot that he wrote. We say Tfilat Barchi Nafshi, they say the Tirot. There are other things that he says that it can't be the Tirotic, because it's a Turk, it's a Hebrew, but there are many places that say the Tirotic, Nishmat Kol Chai, Tfilat Nishmat Kol Chai, that we say every Shabbat. In Kippur we say the Ten Tehillah, the prayer, that in many Siddur, the Ten Tehillah is a Piyut, Tirotic. Shimon Kefa wrote the same Tehillah that we said Kippurim. This is, no, what I tell you, it's like a Sofan Da Vinci. You know this, you heard about the book of Sofan Da Vinci. But it's much more before. Mm-hmm. Before what we talk about, not 125 years after Jesus. Mm-hmm. We talk about 2 years, 30 years after Jesus, what happened here in Israel. Okay? So, now, you can come, or somebody, a Christian, is a no, Paulus is good, he gives his life for this, it cannot be that he was this. This is not the point. This is not the point. I think Paulus, he did a very good job for the going. There was of the Avodah Zarah, what he did is excellent. I have nothing against Paulus. Mm-hmm. But, the fact that the Judaism, Rocco, hey, and nobody in the Judaism knows this story. It's a secret story. I find it in a place. This story, it is in a book that called Beta Midrash. A Midrash that called Beta Midrash. It's a rare book, but this story is there. I'm not sure if all the story, because there are few versions of this story. It is a version with only Shimon Kefa. And it is a bigger version with Paulus and Shimon Kefa too. Mm-hmm. I find it in a kind of a book that an encyclopedia that has all the... It is... In my book it is written all the place that you can... This story can be found. But it's... The important thing is that almost nobody knows, not Jewish and not Christian. And the historian people don't take it seriously. And but what is important that is recognized that like a true thing, a thing that happened truly. It's important.
Most rabbis don't know this.
They don't either. Well, maybe they know about Shimon Kefa, about Shaul less. They say bad thing about Shaul. About Shimon Kefa, they say good thing. About Shaul, they say bad thing. Because he took all the Torah and make it just, it's enough to believe. Alright? So they don't like Paulus, but they like, for some reason, they like Shimon Kefa. Why do they like Shimon Kefa? Now, we can ask other question. Why he was... He was killed in the day of Jesus born, first person, and why he was killed on the backwards
upside down
like a symbol of the Antichrist. All right.